What's the point? You're not even going to suspend us, right?
Right. What's the point? So we're here, like it or not. If it makes you all feel any better, the word around school is you're down here because you beat the system. You had no interest in being in a classroom, and you made the classroom impossible for everybody else, and now you're out. You won.
Yeah.
You feel like winners?
Always.
That's how we do.
Who's we? Us. No, who are you?
Players.
Kingpins?
Nah, that comes later. Right now, we're just corner boys.
So how long until you're kingpins?
I'm thinking 2-3 years.
2-3 years. Let me ask, and I want everybody to write this down. Where do you see yourself in 10 years? Come on, pencil and paper. This isn't schoolwork. This is about y'all.
She's young, but she's good.
Yeah, doctoral candidate from the psych department at College Park. Thesis work is on social alienation among adolescents.
All right, show of hands. How many wrote MBA?
Yeah, but only for the Lakers, though.
I want to be a pediatric neurosurgeon like that one nigga. What's his name?
Ben Carson.
Yeah, that dude.
He's a black surgeon. Hopkins and Bob.
You want to be a surgeon, you need to go to medical school.
Whatever.
How many wrote down dead?
Shit, you saw that coming, huh?
Shame y'all have so little time and you're wasting it here with us. You know where you're going, and we can't teach you anything you don't know about that, right?
I'm in 12th grade, I'm 18, and I'm from Charlottesville, Virginia.
My name is Molly Rickabaugh, I'm a junior at Albemarle High School.
I'm Bethany.
Where are you from?
I'm from here, I'm from Charlottesville.
All right, and you're a senior, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm Malin Garrison, I'm from Charlottesville, and I'm a junior. Go to PVCC and then go to another two-year college, and study something that where I can help others.
Yeah, in the summer I'm gonna take a CNA class and become a CNA and then go to PVCC. My grandma had cancer and so I took care of her a lot, and so it's just kind of stuck with me.
Well, I want to go through PVCC and then UVA, and after that hopefully a military route.
First I was gonna go to like PVCC and just try to get like the first 2 years, and then
and when I go to college?
I'm going to VCU for art. I'm not sure, I mostly work with ceramics and I really like sculpture. And so I'd like to find a way to be able to do that either for like an own business that I start or for a company that does something. So I'd like to be able to do art. I'm also interested in graphic design, and there's a lot of opportunities for that.
So I definitely want to go to college. I've toured a bunch of colleges. I want to do something with science, that's my main goal, or with people, or both. I've been looking into occupational therapy as one of the choices. I really like JMU, I like the relaxed feel. I also liked Mary Washington and West Virginia University. Those are probably my top three.
My boyfriend actually is a CNA, and I just like helping people.
Yeah.
Probably my mom and my dad, mostly just because like how they grew up, and they're like, you need to go to college, and like, I want you to be better. I really like respect how hard they work, and I don't want to work that hard.
Probably my ceramics teacher, she's incredible, and then my sister, she also did ceramics. She does more wheel thrown than sculpture, but they both influenced me a lot to want to do that with my life.
Well, definitely my parents have influenced me to reach these goals, and my grandparents as well. They've been a big inspiration.
Yes.
I think it's my family, because they've pushed me so much, and then also like the leaders at my youth group, because they show me how like you don't have to be what the rest of the world is, but just who you are. maybe like an occupational therapist for children, or like working for a company called IJM. IJM is the International Justice Mission.
Okay.
They help like people get out of situations where they go through, like, where girls might go through like sex trafficking, and they help go through like the whole process of it.
I went to Vida Nours,
mm-hmm.
so that's what I wanna go college
mm-hmm.
to take my classes. I'm working in Nours. Maybe I have a husband and
yeah.
children.
Hopefully, like, own my own house. That's what really my dream is, just owning my own house and, like, living on my own. I don't want to live on my own, especially after, like, college, even in high school.
Yeah.
I just want to be on my own, like, independent.
Hopefully, I'll get my RN. I guess depending if I'm still with my boyfriend.
Yeah.
Like, I guess maybe settling down if we're, like, financially stable, maybe having a kid.
Hopefully in the Army or Navy.
Yeah.
Hopefully I want to be in for like 20 years or so. I kind of want to do the same thing my father did. He was an Army Ranger, so I wanted to just continue along those lines, hopefully. So that's the Army route. Hopefully in 10 years I'm there.
I imagine myself probably a hospital, helping people. I just want to help people. And I don't know, hopefully in a nice house, nice neighborhood, yeah. kind of relaxed.
Hopefully, I know VCU has a bunch of really good, since it's such a good art program, they have it's set up so that you could find a job outside of like once you graduate, and so hopefully I'll be able to find something along the lines of my major mm-hmm. with sculpture or graphic design. I don't know, I'd like to like have a like not a house but like a place and
yeah.
like a life and be doing what I like to do, and mm-hmm. if not then like something along the lines to be able to support myself.
I would want like because I want to travel a lot to different countries to experience different cultures too,
mm-hmm.
and just to have a job that I love and to be able to help other people too.
In Colombia, my country.
I went to the Dominican Republic for spring break, and I'd probably, as of now, say I would want to live there.
And I want to live in Florida, and so, because I like the beach. I just like, I don't know, anywhere I guess that has a good career for me.
I do love Pennsylvania, and I also love Virginia. It's a great state, so either one of those.
I really do like it here, but I also would like to live in like Oregon or California. I like the nature around them. Like Oregon, it's definitely I don't know, it's just nice there
mm-hmm.
and stuff. And I just like the weather, yeah.
It's okay. I mean, it's normal. Great teachers, great academic schedule and stuff. I'm just kind of tired of it. I was ready to leave last year, but
yeah.
It's fun though. It's one of the best schools in the area.
It's a great opportunity.
Yeah.
For a star career.
I like it, but right now it's stressful
mm-hmm.
because of junior year. But I think that it's a very good experience to have.
I like it. I like how there's a lot of different people from a lot of different places, and we're all in this place where we can get to know one another and express ourselves in different ways. And there's lots of different clubs that you can be a part of, so I like it.
Well, Albemarle, I think, is different from most high schools. It's much bigger and much more diverse, and so it's not like the cliche high school where you have the cliques and stuff. It's more just friend groups that hang out and stuff. And so it's not like, from the social aspect, it's not all that like pressure
mm-hmm.
or difficult. And then the academics is really good.
Parties. I like go party with friends.
I used to play basketball, but I broke my ankle, so I kind of quit that. I don't know. I go to like my Spanish teacher. She's like really sweet, and she helps me through stuff.
Yeah.
So it's like someone I can go to and talk to.
Now I like to play sports. I'm on the lacrosse team. I like to, believe it or not, I like to use schoolwork sometimes. It's just the feeling of accomplishment when you're done. It's fun. Other than that, just hanging out with friends outside of school, going to the beach,
hey.
Vacation, that's fun.
Yeah. So I am in the color guard here, which is lots of fun. I also, I babysit, and I have a job at Harris Teeter. I'm just a cashier. And then I'm also in a youth group.
I just like play hockey, usually.
Hey.
It's just something like, one, stress relieving, and stay in shape, and you're just kind of, it's something fun to do.
me and my best friend talk about it, and she wants to go into PVCC for like Homeland Security type stuff. We're definitely close enough that we wouldn't drift off after high school, so we'd always stay in touch.
Well, not during freshman and sophomore year, but especially in junior year, we've been stressed about the future and we've talked about it a lot. Well, I have some friends that are for sure what they want to do and they've planned out their whole entire future. Then I have other friends who are like, I have no idea what I want to do, and they're sort of freaking out. So it's kind of diverse in that way. Depends on the person, really.
Yeah, actually, we're pretty all over. One of my buddies wants to be, right now he's taking a class at the MATS school, public policy and leadership, right. And he wants to go on that route, just hopefully like CIA, like FBI route. That's what he tells me. He likes that type of stuff.
Yeah.
And some of my friends just want to be like landscapers. Some of my friends want to go into the sport fields and stuff like that, like hopefully become a professional athlete. And some military, so we're very diverse.
I'm mostly friends with people that, like my boyfriend, he wants to go into the army and stuff like that, and so they definitely have like more of a plan versus other high schools who are just in high school.
I guess like right now, like financially with PVCC and all that, I'm scared like maybe I won't get the type of job I wanted or like pursue into getting my RN. I'm not really good at school, but like I want to go bad enough to get my RN.
I think they're afraid of like when they pick what they want to do that they're not actually going to like it. So they're trying to figure out who they are, and before they have to figure out that, they figure out what they do after figuring out who you are. Because I think high school is kind of that place where you got to figure out where you fit in and what you love to do, and that kind of determines your future.
I guess making the future and like my life down the road like as good as it can be without having to struggle or like get into problems and stuff.
I mostly just think of like I want to be doing what I like to do while being able to support myself, because that is sometimes difficult to do.
I'm a little, of course, everyone's afraid of the future, and that's a big thing, but I'm afraid of not making it, but again, I'm going to try my hardest to make it, and I think as long as I try my hardest, I'm going to be okay wherever I end up.
Wow. I think, especially in the classes where I work, my students really want to excel at whatever job that they're looking towards. A lot of my students aren't taking the college route or going to junior college or community college for, a few years. So I think a lot of them are focused on careers and making the best effort that they can to excel in that. But even removed from like a vocational aspect, I think they truly want to enjoy what they do. I've got a lot of kids who don't want to not like whatever they're doing. And so I think especially at that age, this idea of like happiness over a long period of time is such a overwhelming feeling that even if they're making a ton of money, they want to be happy doing what they're doing, which is pretty cool to see. I think when pressed on it, they are. I think it's always something in their mind. I teach every grade, so the seniors, obviously, your future is right around the corner. For the freshmen, it's not as present, but when you push them and say, why are you doing the things that you're doing, a lot of times they'll sit back and either say that it's because that they're looking at their futures or realize that what they're doing isn't the best because of the future. So, no, I don't.
Yeah.
I think the word opportunity is a really overused term. I think if you want to look at this nice utopian view of opportunity, then yes, every single student has the same opportunity to achieve. But I have students who are born into really, really bad situations. And so the opportunities that they have are so much harder to come by, which means I don't think they have the same opportunities as everyone else. And so I think a huge job of the people coming into their lives is to try to change that and give them the opportunities that they need. And so many of my students will achieve some of the things that they weren't, the society might not have expected them to. But that's because they've had to work harder to find other opportunities to get from point A to point B, which for some students is fairly simple. something as easy as college. I mean, some of my kids can't afford college, and they won't be able to go to college because of that. But they're going to find themselves in the same positions after college as many of the kids who did go to a four-year university, but they've had to take a different way to get there. So.